Firstly, if there's a colour contrast in the image, like with these flowers, it's very easy and quick to cut out because the background colour's different. You can go to Select, then Colour Range, and pick the background colour. As you can see, there's pixels being selected that we don't want, so increase the fuzziness slider until they go. You don't want it to be so fuzzy that it starts to select the colour from what you want to keep, but it needs to be fuzzy enough so the background gets selected fully. When you're happy, press OK. The background will now be selected. Right-click on it and choose Select Inverse. This selects what you want to keep and ignores the background. Press Ctrl-C to copy and then Ctrl-V to paste. You'll now have a new transparent layer with just the cutout image that you want. That's the easiest and quickest way to do it, but your image might be more complicated. For example, this one looks to have really good contrast, but actually if you look at certain parts of the dog, like here on the face, as well as the ears and body, you can see that the light bits are very similar to the background. That means that if I try to use Colour Range to select the background, I'll end up with parts of the dog being selected, as you can see from this preview. I could just lower the fuzziness so that the dog isn't included, but then you end up with all these fragments of the background. And when you look closer, the dog isn't actually very well cut out anyway. That's because despite looking solid, the background is actually made up of several different shades of the same colour. You can see this when I select parts of it with the magic wand tool. These aren't visible to the naked eye, but Photoshop picks up the colour difference. The quickest way to cut out an image like this is by increasing the tolerance of the magic wand so it selects a wider area. A tolerance of about 50 results in too much of the dog being selected in this case, whereas 10 results in too little background being selected. This'll need to be adjusted based on the image that you're using. For this one, about 20 seems good. It's got all the background selected, and just a few light areas of the dog on the ear and the collar, which we can fix up easily afterwards. We can do that by selecting the lasso tool. You can see from the icon that it's just a normal lasso at the moment, but if you hold down shift, it changes to a plus sign, and if you hold down alt, it changes to a minus sign. We want to remove some of the selection of the dog, so we only have the background. So hold down alt and just drag around the areas that have been selected but need to go. The lasso tool will remove the selection of what you want to keep, leaving only the background. Once you've done that, you can right click, select inverse again, and the parts you want to keep will be selected. Again, Ctrl C and Ctrl V to paste the dog onto a new layer, and you can see that it's very well cut out as well. Good boy. Finally, if you've got an image like this with a lot of similar colours, you'll want to cut out the desired part manually. That's because the colours are too similar to use the colour range or the magic wand without getting messed up. Since it's going to need precision, you can zoom in and out by holding down Alt on your keyboard while scrolling up and down with your mouse. Alternatively, you can use the magnifying glass here, which takes a bit longer but does the same thing. There's the option of using the lasso tool from before to cut out an object, but you'll need a very steady hand to go around the whole thing without mistakes. You might prefer to use the magnet version, which you can access by right-clicking on the lasso tool, then choosing magnetic lasso. Click to set a start point and then slowly move around the image that you want to cut out. It automatically identifies the image that you want as you move around. You can change the frequency that it plots the points on a scale of 1 to 100, 100 meaning it's constantly putting points down like this. When you lower the number, the points become less frequent. I actually prefer it to plot points less frequently because it gives you more control over the image. You can manually add points where necessary by clicking down. Magnetic lasso will do a great job if the image is in focus and there's a clear contrast like on the right-hand side of the strawberry, but can struggle on the left-hand side where things aren't so clear. In this case, you might want to use the pen tool instead. It's slower but allows you to be more accurate because you've got full control. You click to set a line between two points. Then you can hover your mouse in between the points and you see the icon change to have the plus symbol. Click again and it'll place another point in the middle, which is movable. Hold Ctrl down and you'll be able to move the point up and down, as well as arching it from side to side. You can use this feature to pull the line around the shape so you end up with a really smooth curve all the way around. It's just a case of going around the shape steadily until you're finished. When you're done, click the original point to complete the shape. Then right-click in the middle and choose Make Selection to select the shape that you've just made. Press OK on this dialog box, and then Ctrl-C and Ctrl-V to copy and paste it into a new layer. So in summary, if there's a clear contrast, use Colour Range because it's the quickest way to cut something out. If it's not so clear, the quickest method is using the magic wand combined with the lasso to tidy things up. And if there's way too many contrasting colours, you should use the magnetic lasso or pen tool for more accuracy. If you don't have Photoshop, you can use Photopea, which is free and web-based. As you can see, it's got all the same tools that I've mentioned in Photoshop. If you're interested in using these design skills to make passive income online, check out my other videos to learn how. Thanks.